A popular web design trend I've been seeing a lot more of lately has been fading sections, which are these. They are sections that are like testimonials, images, videos, and well, anything that is in a section that fades out at the bottom. So what I'm gonna do in this video is show you how to create this effect in both Elementor and in Bricks. And I got timestamps inside the description so you can skip to the part that matters to you most. All right, let's check it out. Let's start with Elementor and we're going to apply this effect to a few sections here. First one is gonna be this big image. Then we'll add the fading effect to this video right here, then to a grid with this testimonial grid. We'll make it fade off here at the bottom. Then we'll do the same thing to a couple of light versions, just so you can see what it's like for light and dark versions. Now the first step is we need to add the CSS snippet right here. This is all we need to create this effect, and then we are going to be adding this fade section class to our containers that we want faded. So let's go ahead and copy this and go to wherever you are adding your CSS, whether it is in your child theme or in a CSS plugin. For this video, just to make things go fast, I'm going to use my customize. And the customize sometimes for me is a good place to add it when I'm in development mode, and then I'll migrate it over to where I'm managing all my CSS. I am just going to copy this class. That way I could add it to my containers. All right, let's go over to the first one. We are going to go over here to your outer container, go over to advanced, and then add it into your classes. Make sure you don't have that dot in there, by the way, just the text right here, fade section. Now go over to your style and we are targeting the background overlay. So what is happening with the CSS is we are going to push the background overlay to on top of your content. All right, so we're going to choose gradient. And this is really important. Make sure you change this to the same exact color as your background, so that way it flows in smoothly. We're gonna make it the same color in both, the same color in the background. Change your opacity to 1. And by now, everything should be covered. If it's not covered, go back over to your CSS snippet and you could increase your Z index by up to 100 or 1000. Now back over to our overlay. What we're gonna do over here is on the top one, go to your color and drag this all the way down to a 0 opacity. You want it to be clear. Now we can see the fade already happening, but we gotta play with our locations. So start to change the location. You first wanna bring this one up because you don't really want the fade to go over any of the content. So you're gonna move this down a bit and you can see it's right around here. If we keep going, you can see it moving. And then we could also adjust this up. Okay, maybe right around here. So that looks good. We got a fade right here. Let's go take a look in the front. And we can see now we got that faded effect going on. And it is that easy. We could apply this to several different types of items right here that are really dope. One thing I like to apply this on, and I like when I see it on sites, are going to be videos when it is a large video. So check this out. Let's do it to this video right here. I'll go ahead and add in the class, go over to our style. We're going to go to our background overlay, our gradients, and then make sure we choose the same colors for both sides. Change the opacity all the way to 1. Come back over to the top gradient up here, the top color, change it to 0, and then let's go ahead and play with the location until it looks about right. So I'm going to take this down quite a bit because I do want the top of the video showing to be kind of clear. So I'm going to take this to 70. Let's see, I might have to adjust it, but then I want to move this up a bit. And this is why I like this effect right here. Okay, this looks pretty good. Let's save this and let's take a look at it in the front. And check this out. This is what I like. We could play the video and the video will stay faded right here. So it's a pretty cool effect to use. It's pretty dope, right? All right, now let's do it to one more. And this is a different style as well. And this is a very popular style that I'm seeing a lot right now, which is testimonial grids that are fading out. So we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna go to our outer container, add in our class, and then go over to our style and our background overlay and add in our gradient. Again, keeping the background color the same. changing the opacity to 1, and then let's take this all the way down to transparent, and let's play with the location. All right. Now let's move this up a bit. Let's take a look at all of the sections that we built. So we got our fading image, our video, and then we got this fading testimonial grid. Then to apply this effect in the light version, it's straightforward. It's the same exact thing. Let's do this in the outer container. We're going to go back to our CSS classes. We're going to add in the fade section. The only difference is from the other ones that we built is the color. So we just match the color that is in the background. For this one, it is a tan color. So let me add the tan on both, opacity to 1. And then let's move this top one all the way down to 0 opacity and then play around with our locations. I'm going to drop this one down. I'm going to drop it down quite a bit, and then I am going to move it up. I just want that bottom border invisible. That is pretty much my goal. All right, there we go. So let's update this, and let's take a look at it in the front. So look it, check it out. There it is. Play around with it. Now, the good thing about this as well is you can still copy and paste the text. You can still put links in here. The background overlay isn't blocking any links or anything. Now, let's go ahead and do this in bricks, because bricks actually is a whole lot easier because we don't need any CSS. I'm going to apply it to this section right here with these testimonials. So I'm going to make sure I'm on my section element. I'm going to go up over here to my pseudos, and I am going to select on before. Now that before is active, I'm going to go to layout and then to my Z index. I'm going to put in 100 just to be safe. Really, all you need to do is add 1, but I like to be a little extra safe sometimes. All right, let's click this off so we are not targeting pseudos. Instead, let's now add in our background overlay. I'm going to go here, apply to overlay. And then I'm going to add in my colors. And again, I'm going to make sure it's the same color as in the background. And we can see it's already blacking everything out. And now I'm going to play with the color stop. Let me take this to 50% just to see where it's at. Already, it's looking pretty good. I mean, I could move this up or down, and I could just play around with it like what we did in Elementor until we find the right fade that we want. And we can see here, we got that fade effect. A whole lot easier in bricks once you know what to look for to target this and create this effect. If you're using Elementor and want to copy and paste the CSS, I got a link inside the description that'll take you to the blog post that has all the information, making it a lot easier for you to create this effect. And if you are interested in more web design tuts like this, then don't forget to like and subscribe. I really appreciate the support, and I look forward to being back with some more fun web design stuff like this. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you for watching.